You better think, think about what's trying to do to me. Yeah, think that you might not let yourself be free. Oh, freedom. Welcome to Critical Thinking, a Reasoning Experience. I'm Pamela Iraosa from General Arts and Science at George Brown College.
For having everyone write out a job description, that way management can assess who's valuable
and who's expendable.
Success at work depends on our abilities as critical thinkers. Employers prefer graduates who are problem solvers and decision makers. They want people who can apply and adapt what they know to the challenges of the workplace.
We're trying to get a feel for how people spend their day at work. So if you would you walk us through a typical day for you?
Yeah.
Great.
Well, I generally come in at least 15 minutes late. I use the side door, that way Lumberg can't see me. and after that, I just sort of space out for about an hour.
Space out?
Yeah.
Critical thinking skills, such as problem solving and decision making, are also necessary for success at school, in our communities, at home, and in our personal relationships. What are the characteristics of a critical thinker? Critical thinkers are willing to look at themselves honestly. They are aware of their prejudices. They know their attitudes and values influence what they think, say, and do. They are fair, respectful, and willing to examine and change their habits of thinking. Critical thinkers are not easily manipulated. They ask questions and base their judgments on evidence. They recognize and evaluate opinions by distinguishing between facts and assertions. They are comfortable with complexity and look for connections among ideas. They are independent thinkers. They form opinions carefully. They are willing to reconsider any opinion or conviction. They are open to new ideas and may be influenced by an argument that is supported by persuasive evidence. What is an argument?
You just contradicted me.
No, I didn't.
Oh, you did.
No.
You did just then.
No, nonsense.
Oh, look, this is futile.
No, it isn't.
I came here for a good argument.
No, you didn't. You came here for an argument.
Well, an argument's not the same as contradiction.
Can be.
No, it can't. An argument is a connected series of statements to establish a definite proposition.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. It isn't just contradiction.
Look, if I argue with you, I must take up a contrary position.
But it isn't just saying no, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
Loud disagreement is one kind of argument. But in critical thinking, by argument we mean a line of reasoning that depends on persuasive evidence to provide support for the main idea. In evaluating arguments, critical thinkers recognize and avoid fallacies, that is, errors in reasoning that attempt to persuade by intentionally or unintentionally distorting information, misleading the reader or audience, or relying on inappropriate appeals to emotions such as guilt, fear, and pity. Is critical thinking still so important in our high-tech information age? Reasoning and thinking critically are foundational to problem-solving and decision-making in all areas of knowledge and experience. The multimedia communications environment we inhabit requires us as critical thinkers to constantly evaluate arguments that intervene subtly, explicitly, editorially, and persuasively in both the public and private spaces of our lives. The world of advertising, public culture, and the news media, our workplaces, our academic and personal lives, all require the daily and constant exercise of critical thinking. What can we expect from this course? Critical thinking, a reasoning experience, will develop your willingness and ability to ask and answer the critical questions that are necessary to systematically evaluate information, facts, and opinions. You will use critical questions actively and appropriately to evaluate arguments and conclusions and to judge the quality of what you hear and read. You will develop your ability to formulate reasoned opinions, develop valid arguments, and arrive at logical conclusions. This course provides a strong foundation for your program of study. Students who apply themselves also find it both interesting and relevant because it is very useful in its application to their everyday lives. How much you will benefit from this course will depend on you. I encourage you to get on track from the outset, apply yourself throughout the course, and set yourself on the way to becoming a truly thinking individual.